Vamos pro page number. Come to page number 9.25, illustration number 10. Come to page number 9.25, illustration number 10. You are not practicing anything.
Yes.
You are not listening properly. I told. I hope you are not practicing anything.
Yes.
We should agree with that. No.
Yes,
what happened, Santosh? Circus. Viral. Let us read this problem, let us finish it. Page number 9.25 of your textbook. Problem number 10. The following is a receipts and payments account of Lion Club for the year ended 31st March 2012. Receipts, opening balance of cash, opening balance of bank is given to you. It is not bank balance as per passbook, it is as per our books only. Subscription received 2,02,750. What is subscription? If you want to enjoy the services of the club, you have to keep paying some, you can say, periodical fees to the club. That is called a subscription. Subscribe means you agree to take the services, you want the services from the club, and the consideration in return you have to pay subscription. You want to continue to be the member of ICA, you have to pay some membership fees. It's also a subscription. Entrance donation, 1 lakh rupees. So some new people wanted to get admitted into the club. They also wanted the services of the club. So initially some entrance donation was requested and they have paid some money to the club, 1 lakh rupees. Interest received, 58,000. Sale of assets 8,000, miscellaneous income 9,000, receipts at coffee room, wines and spirits, swimming pool, tennis court. So the club is providing various facilities to its members, and when it's providing those services, it is charging some amount to the members, and it is shown as a collection. Payments, salaries, credit hours, printing and stationery, postage, telephone and telex, repairs and maintenance, glass and table linen, crockery and cutlery, garden upkeep, membership fees, insurance, electricity, closing balance, cash and bank. They are given all the payments of the club. The assets and liabilities as on 1st April 2011 were as follows. Fixed assets, net. So at the beginning of the year, net of depreciation, fixed asset value was 5 lakh. Stock, opening stock is given to you, 3,80,000. Investment in 12% government securities, 5 lakh. Outstanding subscription, 12,000. Prepaid insurance, 1,000. Sundry credit hours, 1,12,000. Subscription received in advance, 15,000. Entrance donation received, pending membership, 1 lakh. Gratuity fund, 1,50,000. So you are given all the opening figures of assets and liabilities. So last year also, just observe, last year also we have received some entrance donation. Entrance donation received, pending membership. That means last year also few people have applied to become members of the club. They have given some entrance fees, but they were not yet granted membership. Maybe the meeting of the club did not, the meeting of the executive committee of the club did not take place. So their applications were not processed. And we can say the money is still with the club. Membership has not been granted yet. So we have kept that money in suspense. Gratuity fund, 1,50,000. What is gratuity fund? So employees who are working in the club to provide services, I think you all know, we have to provide them some gratuity. So there is a gratuity fund of 1,50,000. The following adjustments are to be made while drawing up the accounts. Subscription received in advance as on 31st March 2012 was 18,000. So this is closing subscription received in advance. Outstanding subscription as on 31st March 2012, that is subscription receivable at the end of the year, 7,000. Outstanding expenses are salaries 8,000, electricity 15,000. 50% of the entrance donation was to be capitalized. There was no pending membership as on 31st March 2012. The cost of assets sold net as 1st April 2011 was 10,000. Depreciation is to be provided at the rate of 10% on assets. A sum of rupees 20,000 received in October 2011 as entrance donation from an applicant was to be refunded as he has not fulfilled the requisite membership qualification. So a particular person applied to become a member of the club, maybe he has not satisfied the membership requirements, hence we are going to refund the amount to him. The refund was made on 3rd June 2012, that is at after the close of the financial year. Purchases made during the year amounted to 15 lakh. The value of clothing stock was 2,10,000. The club, as a matter of policy, charges off to income and expenditure account all purchases made on account of crockery, cutlery, glass, linen in the year of purchase. What do you mean by crockery, cutlery, glass, linen in the year of purchase? Crockery is those plates, teacups, etc., saucers. Cutlery, spoons, knives, etc. Glass. Linen is the tablecloth and all, etc. You are required to prepare an income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2012 and balance sheet as on 31st March 2012 along with necessary workings. Let us start. So you are required to prepare income and expenditure account, balance sheet for the year ended as on 31st March 2012. And are we given the capital fund balance in the problem? We are not given, hence we have to prepare even the opening balance sheet to calculate the opening capital fund balance. So let us start. Income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2012. Balance sheet as on 31st March 11, opening balance sheet. Balance sheet as on 31st March 2012. Liabilities rupees. Assets rupees. Liabilities rupees. Assets rupees. So I'll start using the rupee symbol from now. Here I started. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Ready, everyone? We always have an order of solving the problem, no? on one particular order. You have read the entire problem now. Let us start with the receipt side of the income and expenditure account. Pick up all necessary relevant adjustments and show them in our income and expenditure account balance sheets. Yes, and prepare necessary working notes wherever we require. Opening balance of cash and bank 10,000 and 3,850. We show it in the opening balance sheet. Cash balance, bank balance first, then cash balance. Bank, cash. Tell me the figures.
10,000.
Okay. Bank and cash. Subscription received 2,02,750 rupees. Subscription received. We have received subscription of 2,02,750 rupees. You pass an entry cash or bank account or to subscription account. Can I show the same amount in the income and expenditure account? Is amount received equal to amount of income to be recognized? No, because you have adjustments relating to opening receivable, closing receivable, opening received in advance, closing received in advance. You have to make all those adjustments and only then we'll arrive at subscription income. We will prepare a small working note, not an account. If the problem says prepare subscription account, then you'll open the account. Working note number one. Subscription income to be recognized. Subscription income to be recognized. Write down. Amount received. How much is the amount received? Please tell me. 2,02,750 was received. Add receivable at the end. Add receivable at the end. Please tell me how much is receivable at the end of the year.
31st March 2012
is the end of the year date. Outstanding subscription as on 31st March 2012 is 7,000. Receivable at the end of the year, 7,000. Then less received in advance at the end. How much? 18,000. Then add received in advance beginning. Received in advance beginning. Less receivable beginning. Receivable beginning. Outstanding subscription, you can see page number 9.26. Outstanding subscription 12,000. Receivable at the beginning 12,000. Now you will get subscription income. ₹1,94,70. Income in the income and expenditure account by subscription 1,94,750. And rest of the relevant items in the balance sheet also. Subscription receivable. Beginning. 12,000. Subscription advance beginning. 15,000. Subscription advance. Ending. 18,000. Subscription receivable. Ending. 7,000. Is it clear, everyone? Next. Entrance donation received 1 lakh rupees during the year. Please see the relevant information given in the last year also. 1st April 2011, entrance donation was also received pending membership 1 lakh. Last year, entrance donation received 1 lakh. Current year, entrance donation received 1 lakh, 2 lakh. But when the executive committee of the club met, and when they went through the application forms of the applicants who wanted to become the member of the club, we found that one of the applicants did not meet the qualification criteria, hence we were removing him. We are not going to allow him to become a member of the club. We decided to refund how much? 20,000 rupees to him. Is it clear? And then read point number 4. 50% of the entrance donation was to be capitalized, and there was no pending membership as on 31st March 2012. So write down working note number 2. Can I write the first working note? Entrance donation to be capitalized. To be capitalized means what? Out of the amount collected, how much should be taken to the balance sheet and how much should be transferred to the income and expenditure account. You're right. Amount received last year 1 lakh plus current year 1 lakh total 2 lakh less refundable, not refunded yet. As on 31st March, it's only refundable. The amount was refundable on 1st June. We are preparing accounts as on what date? On 31st March. So we know that some amount is refundable, which will be refunded on 1st June. 20,000 is refundable. Balance 1,80,000. Capitalized at the rate of 50%, 90,000
transferred to
income and expenditure account, 90,000. Scheme of entries. Last year, listen to me carefully, last year when entrance donation was received, we pass the entry cash or bank account at R to entrance donation account. Entrance donation account was not transferred to the income and expenditure account in the last year. It was brought forward to the current year. Similarly, in the current year also we have received some donations for becoming a member of the club. We pass the entry cash or bank account at R to entrance donation account. This way, entrance donation account started showing 2 lakhs of credit balance. Then we came to know that out of the amount collected, some amount is refundable. So we have reduced it from entrance donation account and will transfer it to refundable account. We'll pass an entry. Entrance donation account debtor. Entrance donation account debtor to entrance donation refundable account. What is entry we are going to pass? Entrance donation account debtor to entrance donation refundable account. And when the amount is refunded, the amount was refunded on 1st June. So when the amount is refunded, we'll pass the entry entrance donation refundable account debtor to bank account. Okay. So right now the refund did not take place by the end of the year. So what is the entry you have to pass to make the amount due? Entrance donation account debtor to entrance donation refundable account. Once you pass this entry, 2 lakh minus 20,000, 1 lakh 80,000 will be the credit balance left in the entrance donation account. Out of 1 lakh 80,000, the club has decided to take 50% to revenue and take 50% as we can say a fund in the balance sheet. They have decided to capitalize 50% of the entrance donation and treat the remaining 50% as a revenue receipt. Is it clear? So, capitalized amount will be shown in the balance sheet. Remaining amount will be shown in the entrance donation. 90,000. Last year, please tell me how much was entrance donation in the balance sheet? 1 lakh. Current year entrance donation? Entrance donation 90,000. Or you can transfer this amount to the capital fund also. Entrance donation refundable. How much? 20,000. Again, I'll tell you the scheme of entries. Last year, an amount was received, cash or bank account, debtor to entrance donation account. Entrance donation account showed a credit balance in the last year books, hence it was shown on the balance sheet liability side. Current year, we received some more amount, we passed the entry, cash or bank account, debtor to entrance donation account. Entrance donation account balance increased to 2 lakh. If no adjustment was done, entrance donation account would have appeared in the balance sheet liability side 2 lakh because it is showing a credit balance. Okay, it's a source. Money is coming in, no, it's a source. So we are going to show that source as entrance donation 2 lakh. Now, during the year we came to know that out of 2 lakh, 20,000 is refundable, not refunded yet. Refundable. So we pass an entry. What is entry we pass? Debit entrance donation account, credit entrance donation refundable account. What is entry we are going to pass? Entrance donation account debtor to entrance donation refundable account. By passing this entry, entrance donation refundable account will show a credit balance. That is why it is showing on the balance sheet liability side, entrance donation refundable. Because of passing that entry, entrance donation account balance will reduce to 1,80,000. And now it is showing, still showing credit balance. 2 lakhs credit, 20,000 debit, it is still showing 1,80,000 credit. Now what should we do with that? The club has decided to take 50% to revenue and take 50% to the balance sheet. So out of 1,80,000, we have transferred to income and expenditure account 90,000. We have passed an entry there. Entrance donation account debtor to income and expenditure account. Entrance donation account balance will reduce. Income and expenditure account will be credited. The remaining balance of 90,000 is shown in the balance sheet. This can be shown here, or you can close entrance donation account, transfer the balance to the capital fund or the general fund of the trust. Is it clear? Next. Interest received 58,000. See the 1st April 2011 figures. Investment in 12% government securities 5 lakh. So please take your calculators. Type 5 lakh into 12% for the full year. There is no mention of sale of investments during the year, hence investments were outstanding throughout the year. 5 lakh into 12%, how much is it? 60,000 is the total interest income, but how much interest was collected during the year? 58,000. What is the difference? What is that? It is accrued interest, interest due but not received, or interest receivable, or accrued interest. Is it clear? So where will show interest income? Income and expenditure account. By interest on investments. Inner column 58,000 plus accrued 2000, total 60,000. Show it as an asset. Closing balance sheet. Accrued interest. Next, sale of assets 8,000. Now look at the board. Look at the book. Sorry, 1st April 2011. Fixed assets net worth 5 lakh. Opening balance was 5 lakh. So let us show that information. Fixed assets net 5 lakh. During the year, some assets have been sold. And there is also some depreciation, so can we show a working note?
Yeah.
So let us show a working note. Working note number 3 now?
Yeah.
Working note number 3, profit or loss on sale of asset. What is the cost price of the asset and what is the sale price of the asset? Sale price of asset 8,000 less cost price of asset sold 10,000. So answer is negative 2,000 loss. Loss 2,000. Not over yet. We will continue the next working note also. Calculation of closing WDV. Calculation of closing WDV. Calculation of closing WDV.
Opening
balance. How much is the opening balance, please tell me?
5 lakh.
Less
cost price
of
cost of asset sold
10,000.
Balance
4,90,000. Do you have any accretions, additions, increase of assets? No. Of 4,90,000, now
depreciation.
Less
depreciation at the rate of 10%.
49,000 is depreciation.
WDV
4,49,000. Now we have to show the relevant information in the income and expenditure account and balance sheet. Loss on sale of asset. I will show somewhere here. True loss on sale of asset. Loss I am showing here. What you should do is in your exam you have to give reference of that working note. Working note number 3. Or you can use a simple like this. Note number 3. Ash. Next. WDV. Closing WDV of the fixed asset we are going to show here. Fixed asset WDV. 4,41,000. Depreciation also we have to charge. To depreciation 49,000. Four. Let us continue. Miscellaneous income 9000. Did you find any adjustment relating to miscellaneous income anywhere in the problem?
No.
I did not find any adjustment, so I'll straight away take it as income. By miscellaneous income. How much?
9000
rupees. By miscellaneous income, 9000 rupees. Next. Receipts at coffee room, wines and spirits, swimming pool, tennis court, etc. So we are getting some income by providing some services to the club members or by selling goods to the club members. Instead of showing the sales and the cost in the income and expenditure account, we can show only net proceeds, the net income, net, not gross income, net income from these services in the income and expenditure account, or else the income and expenditure account will become too clumsy. If you show the gross income and expenses here, it is difficult to find out from where the club is getting income and where it is spending. Okay, because everything will get mixed. We'll prepare a working note. Write down. Working note number 5. Calculation of net income from services provided to members of the club. Particulars. Rupees. Receipts, that is nothing but sales. Tell me the total. Are you right? Okay. Coffee room. How much? Coffee room, how much?
10,70,000.
Wines and spirits.
5,10,000.
Swimming pool.
80,000.
Next.
Tennis court.
1,02,000. Less cost of goods sold. Less cost of goods sold. Opening stock. How much is opening stock? Please tell me. See the problem. First April 2011, you are given opening stock figure. How much is it?
380,000.
Add purchases. Purchases 15 lakh. Less closing stock. Closing stock is also given in the problem.
2,10,000.
You will get cost of goods sold. Write it in the outer column.
Sixteen lakh seventy thousand.
Net income. Gross figures, no. Somebody reading your financials will feel so much money is coming from operations. But after meeting expenses, how much is left? Only 92,000. It is better to show 92,000 instead of showing the gross amount of income and gross amount of expense. By net income from services to members. 92,000. I mean, there are certain clubs where services are open only to members. If members want, they can bring their guests also. And whether the member or his guests have something there, they'll charge it. The club is going to charge a bill. So club gets some income out of it. But maybe little less when compared to what is there outside. And club is like, it's not open to everyone. Maybe it's only open to members and their friends and family members. So our friend says there is a waiting period of 25 years for getting membership of the Secunderabad club. Only for army people. No, even army people are lot of people. And you all completed? Okay, now how do we show it? Wait, don't be in a hurry. Show opening stock, closing stock figures. Stock. Stock. You all completed. Next, all receipts are over now. Come to the expenditure side. Salaries 1,20,000 payment. Okay. See the information given to you. Outstanding expenses are salaries 8,000, it is 15,000. So apart from 1,20,000, another 8,000 is outstanding. So you write two salaries. Inner column 1,20,000 plus outstanding 8,000, total 1,28,000. Balance sheet outstanding salary 8,000. Balance sheet you write outstanding salary 8,000. Outstanding. Next, creditors 15,20,000 is your creditors. That is creditors payment. Now, can you calculate the? Are you given the opening creditors figure? Yes. You are given opening creditors. You are given payment to creditor. You are given purchases of goods. You have to calculate closing creditors. Can you calculate?
Yes, sir.
Please prepare a working note. Calculation of closing creditors. Particulars, rupees, right on, opening creditors, how much?
1,12,000.
Add purchases. Add purchases. How much? 15,00,000. Less payment. Payment to creditors. How much? 15,20,000. Closing creditors. opening credit hours plus purchases minus payment to credit hours will give closing credit hours. I think I should separate you people. Only then you will stop talking. Closing credit hours 92,000. Write down. Credit hours at the beginning of the year was 1,12,000. Credit hours, I'll write here, 92,000. I'll write opening credit hours in the opening balance sheet and closing credit hours in the closing balance sheet. You'll write opening credit hours here, closing credit hours here. Next, printing and stationery 70,000. Printing and stationery 70,000. Do you have any outstanding for printing and stationery? So you can straight away write the entire amount in the income and expenditure account. To printing and stationery. Postage 40,000. Do you have anything for postage? No. So you can debit entire postage to income and expenditure account. To postage 40,000. Next, telephone and telex. Do you have any telephone and telex expenses? Outstanding, prepaid, nothing. To TNT. How much? 52,000. Next, repairs and maintenance, 48,000. Do you have any adjustment relating to repairs and maintenance? No. It can be debited to the income and expenditure account. To repairs and maintenance, 48,000. Next, glass and table linen 12,000. The problem clearly said glass and table linen, crockery and cutlery, all those things are going to be debited to the income and expenditure account. They are going to be charged to revenue. What was the item? Glass and table linen. Glass and table linen. How much?
12,000.
Next, to crockery. Crockery and cutlery, how much? 14,000. Garden upkeep, 8,000. Maintenance of the garden. To garden upkeep, how much? 8,000. Membership fees 4,000. To membership fees. This club is a member of some other club. They are also paying membership fees to that club. To membership fees. How much? 4,000. Insurance 5,000. Be careful here. At the beginning of the year, we have some prepaid insurance. Insurance paid 5,000. Prepaid insurance was 1,000, 5,000 minus 1,000, how much is it? 4,000 rupees should appear as an expense, not 4,000, sorry. Insurance paid 5,000. You have opening prepaid. Please tell me, what is the treatment of opening prepaid? Opening prepaid becomes an expense for the current year. We pass an entry. Insurance expense account, debtor are to prepaid insurance account. To insurance, 6,000. Prepaid insurance 1,000. electricity 28,000 plus outstanding 15,000. So how much will be totally? 28 paid, 15,000 outstanding at the end of the year. So total will be 43,000. To electricity. 43,000 in the closing balance sheet, you write outstanding electricity. $28,000 plus $15,000 was written, $43,000. Outstanding electricity in the balance sheet liability side, $15,000. Closing balance of cash and bank, $8,000 and $224,600. Bank balance, $224,600. Cash balance, so we have finished completely all the items of the, where is it? Wait, I just read the receipts and payments account. I'll go to the remaining information now. Fixed assets I've shown opening, closing. Stock I've shown opening, closing. Investment in 12% government securities. Investment in 12% government securities. On stock. Investment in 12% government securities, 5 lakh. During the year it was not sold, hence the same amount will continue. Investment in 12% government securities, 5 lakh. Same amount will continue. Outstanding subscription at the beginning of the year already shown. Prepaid insurance 1000 already shown. Sundry creditors opening shown. Closing also shown. Subscription received in advance 15,000 opening and closing are shown. Entrance donation received pending membership 1 lakh shown. Gratuity fund 1,50,000. Gratuity fund 1,50,000. Here also write gratuity fund. There were no additions to the gratuity fund during the year, no? Yes, sir. Nothing was transferred from the income and expenditure account to the gratuity fund. That's it. Now calculate first of all the opening capital fund balance. Capital fund balancing figure. How much is it? 10 lakh?
29,000.
10 lakh?
29,000.
Capital fund. 10 lakh 29,850 is the opening balance. Calculate the surplus or deficit.
Deficit
you have.
Yes,
sir. By deficit. By deficit. How much? 30?
250.
Less deficit. Closing balance sheet should add. this we finish problem number 10. Number 9.31. We also learn about fund accounting. Come to page number 9.31 quick. Now, you have lot of charitable education institutions. Normally they are run as societies. The society has to be registered under the states. Every state has its own Societies Registration Act. So the societies have to be registered under the Societies Registration Act. And sometimes they are also registered as trusts. Okay. And the state will also have sometimes act relating to the public trust. So you have to get registered under the Public Trust Act also. They are registered either as a society or as a trust. Now, how is a society run?